Okay, another thing you're going to get a lot of in the spring is green garlic. And people have asked me many times, what do you do with green garlic? It's just the immature garlic. It hasn't matured, meaning it hasn't got all papery like you're used to. So what you can do is chop off the top. And I don't really eat this, but if you want a flavor, if you're making soup or stock and you really like that garlic flavor, you can just throw it in. And it's super easy to use green garlic. It's really just like using regular garlic, except the part that's papery when it's fully mature is just kind of, it's, I don't know, it's soft. It's not papery. So it's just like the other way. Just pull that off and you pull out your clove and you use it. And it's delicious. It's not quite as strong as cured garlic, but it really is fresh. And I even made pesto the other day out of that. Okay, so that's your green garlic. Super easy. And the other thing I wanted to quickly talk about was all these greens that you're getting. You might seem overwhelmed with them, but really they cook down so fast. And this is how I prepare my greens. And I'll show you because it's super easy. You just take your greens, whether it's your kale or your chard. This is what I do. And I find the stem to be a little unpalatable, a little tough. So I just take my little finger and I go like that. Whatever comes off, quick. I do this with kale too. Quick, quick, quick. You can do your whole bunch. And then I just chop, 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 chop. That's easy. And then I just throw it in my pan with my butter. Here I have some green garlic and some kohlrabi from earlier. Throw it in, cook it up, and that's it. So easy. And my trick to get my kids to eat all these greens is I just sprinkle it with balsamic vinegar, and that does the trick.